happening right now, and all of you are on the front end of it because the rest of the world is kind of catching up right now. And the fact that you guys are here shows that you saw it first, and you are in for a treat for the next hour and a half. So everybody, give it up for Dr. Jordan Peterson.
Use this chance to talk to all of you to further my thinking on all of these fronts simultaneously. I got invited a week and a half ago to do something that was really an overwhelming honor to me. The Penguin, an imprint of Penguin Books in the UK, is putting out the 50th anniversary version of the Gulag Archipelago.
Wow.
And so, that's really something. Like, I think it's hard to say, you know, you can say, well, I think that's the most important book that was written in the 20th century. And maybe it's not, but it's in the top 10. And it had an overwhelming impact on me. And I want to use the opportunity to write that introduction to do something that needs to be done, that Solzhenitsyn did. I was just in a debate on Saturday in Toronto. It's called the Monk Debates, and I think about 3 million people watched that now. One of the things that I was attempting to get my debate opponents to contend with was the idea that just as the radical right can go too far, that's a claim about which there's virtually no disagreement except, of course, from the radical right, the radical left can go too far. And the historical evidence for that is, to call it overwhelming is to say almost nothing. And one of the things I challenged my opponents to do was to say, well, how do you know when the radical left goes too far? Because they can go too far. And, you know, one of my debating opponents, Michael Dyson, he didn't answer the question at all. Not that he was compelled to or anything, it was up to him. And the other one said, well, you know, when they become violent, which to me is no answer at all, because to say that people have gone too far when they've gone too far isn't helpful. Like, it's just, well, thank you. You know, we're all of us civilized people, assuming that that's what we are against violence. So it's not a very deep analysis. But the problem is that trying to figure out when the radical left has gone too far is actually extraordinarily difficult, because there isn't something that appears to be a smoking pistol. You know, when the radical right starts making claims of racial or ethnic superiority and then starts to react those out in the world, you think, okay, well, you guys are out of the game. Like, that's not acceptable. You're not in the domain of civilized dialogue anymore. But on the left, it's not so obvious when things go off the rails. You know, and one of the things I really liked about reading the Gulag Archipelago, not that I liked reading it, because it's not a book that you like to read. It's like a 1,700-page scream of anguish. You know, it's a really intense book. But what Solzhenitsyn did, and I think it was something that no one had really done before him, was to lay out the evidence that the absolute brutality of the Soviet Union was not an aberration in relationship to Marxist thinking, but a necessary consequence of Marxist thinking. But the problem, of course, is that the argument spans something like 1,700 pages, and that's not concise. And I'm not criticizing the book because of that, because everything in that book needs to be in there, as far as I can tell.